Story. What would you say is the value of life? Well, some say you cannot put a value to it, but one woman in Kisii County paid two men 5,000 shillings each to assassinate her sister-in-law after a fallout over a piece of land. Now, the so-called hitmen were paid a deposit of 3,000 shillings each with the balance promised after proof of death. Well, the good news is the attempted assassination was thwarted after the victim reported the matter to the police. Ovarian Hassan Mugambi has the details.
Maureen Chebet walks the streets of Kisii town constantly looking over her shoulders for fear of being attacked. Just last Saturday, she received credible intelligence that a plot to have her murdered had allegedly been hatched by her sister-in-law over a disputed family property. Maureen reported the intel at Kisii Central Police Station.
Probox ilikuwa imetafutwa, paka imewekwa mafuta, ilikuwa imepangiwa niende nidungwe visu, nitupwe kwa kichaka.
What was even shocking is that in the audio clip evidence Maureen obtained, the supposed hitman could be heard negotiating with the wife to her husband's brother how much each would receive.
Hao watu walikuwa wamepangiwa waniue na 1,000, 5,000. Walikuwa tayari walikubaliana ya kuwa wakinitoa na 3,000. Wakishamaliza kazi wakuja waongezewe 2,000.
The two suspects, 46-year-old William Tengea and 35-year-old Albert Mauti, were arraigned in Kisii with the attempted murder of Maureen Chebet. They were, however, later released on a 10,000 Kenya shillings cash bail each. Nora Nyabongi, the woman who allegedly crafted the whole murder script, was also released on the same terms, a reason Maureen is now fearing for her life.
Naomba sana nisaidiwe nipewe police protection. Tusaidie maisha yangu iko yamo hatarini. Hao watu waliachiliwa na cash bail. Na bado wanatembea wakisema wataniua.
Speaking to Citizen TV on phone, Kisii County Commander Jebel Munene said police are pursuing leads linking the suspects to criminal gangs that terrorize residents in the area. Among the reasons given for the release of the suspects included avoiding crowding remand facilities as a move to contain the spread of COVID-19. Hassan Mugambi, Citizen TV.